You guys want to hear what a clowngasm sounds like? What is up, people? It is I, Sergeant 16-Bit. And here we are again with some animation work. But this time, I actually went ahead and did a little bit of work outside of the stream. Yep, and I'm gonna show that to you right now. So yeah, I made all the frames of Miss Piggy with her lip sync. Yep, there it is. And I made the walk cycle for Kermit. Yeah. In fact, I'm gonna turn on a little bit of autoplay as soon as I turn on onion skin mode and autoplay. Gonna let that load a bit, so there we go. Yeah. Check this out, dudes. Yeah. Whoops. There you go, guys. That there's Kermit doing his walk cycle. Yeah. Alrighty then. Now let's move on to today's scene. Close, damn you. There we go. Make sure I'm on screen. There we go. Okay, so, gonna have little baby Joel talking to his dad, and, first thing I'm gonna do is, first I'm going to make the, necessary frames for Kermit. So, got ourselves our dirt brush, the necessary brush size, whoops, make a new layer, lock this layer, there we go. Now we're talking. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna, since the entire body is going to stay stationary, we're just going to make that its own separate frame, while the head is the only thing that moves. Alright, so let's just get the most awkward area to draw out of the way. Oh boy, man. I mean, kind of had this same, a similar issue drawing in public, drawing the butt or crotch of a character. Because if you're drawing them full body, you're inevitably going to do that. Yeah, for some reason I don't seem to just draw the bust of a character, you know?
Unless we're talking about Mikuru Ashahina.
Ha-ha! But in all seriousness, you know, just their upper body. Yeah, I don't seem to do that a whole lot. Yeah, I like to, you know, draw all of the character. So yeah, I think that's a pretty good habit I've made for myself. Just habitually drawing the entirety of a character. Get some practice in, you know? Anyway, last week I was kinda without a plan for the stream, but this week I actually have something special for you guys. Like, a new thing to stream. Yeah. I'm going to stream the progress of my Kid Chameleon animation, which I had originally planned as something to submit to Sonic Paradox's Sega Shorts. They might still be accepting submissions, but I don't know. I mean, I have it inked. Needs a couple new animation frames. Oh, but I have made the background too. So that shouldn't take too long to complete. Just gotta make like one new frame of Mario jumping. Or two. Either or will do. In any case, if Sega Shorts is still accepting submissions, great. If not, whatever. I like to get things done, you know? Not just leave them unfinished. Now, the reason why I put it off is because of a little inaccuracy I made while making the short. That being, I thought the item blocks in Kid Chameleon had question marks on them, which actually have just the letter P. But they still function very much like the blocks from Mario. So, there's still a joke in there. A pretty ob. I mean. Since not a whole lot of people talk about Kid Chameleon anymore, well, other than those who are huge Sega fans, well, I don't know. The similarities between how the two game franchises function is pretty, how should I put this, surprising. Don't get me wrong, I still like Kid Chameleon, but I can't deny how similar it is to Mardio. Oh yeah, I like to mispronounce things on purpose. Yep, good old Marty. In any case, I'm just gonna keep doing this. Yeah, okay. Here's his beer bottle because I don't know. I like little visual gags like that, you know? I mean, you know, you can really tell a lot about a character from an object he's holding or the expression on his face. Basically, you know, the dead eye expression of this character, plus the beer in his hands, sort of implies that, you know, he's a stressed out guy and, well, he's just sort of taking a break from his life now that he's done with work for the day, you know? Just drinking the blues away for the night. And there's his body. So, whew, got it inked in the span of 8 minutes. Okay. So now let's, pull the last image out so I can reference the colors. Okie dokie. Gonna need the eyedropper tool for this one. And bada bing, bada boom, bada bish, bada whatever. Anyway. And now the beer bottle. There you go. There you go, Kermie. Actually, gonna make the inside of the bottle a little bit darker. Oops. Just, you know, slight touch up. Okay, that's too dark. There you go, Kermie. Drink up. You've earned it. These Steam pop-ups keep getting in the way of the user interface. In any case, time to draw his head. So, definitely looking forward to Halloween in a couple days. 2 more days till Halloween, Halloween, whoops. Halloween, 2 more days till Halloween, Silver Shamrock. Okie dokie then. Of course, in a couple weeks it'll be Halloween Part 2 with the election coming up. Am I right, folks? Yeah. Anyway. topical humor. Just gonna be lazy and copy-paste this eye onto the other. I mean, with deadlines to meet in the professional world, sometimes you have to take shortcuts, as long as they're as harmless as something like this, you know? I mean, not all shortcuts are harmful when it comes to making art. Because, honestly, had I just hand-drawn that other eye, it wouldn't have looked too good. Plus, again, it gets shit done quicker without harming anything. And I gotta say, this character is probably the easiest character I've had to ink and color out of all of these. Because, you know, he's just all green. Oh, man. You know, as much as I value hard work and art, it's nice to have a little break every now and then. So, if you ever find yourself in a position where you've got a little easy job, you celebrate that moment. By golly. You celebrate it and appreciate it. Alright, there's good old Kermie. Now, let's ink and color all the other frames for him. So, let's open up... God, I got a lot of goop in my throat. Let's open up the next file we need. Specifically, that where his head is turning. Yeah, I think I actually showed the progress of me... I mean, process of me animating this back when I first started streaming my progress on this little cartoon. Man, oh man. Let's just label this and this. Okay. Whoop, forgot to merge these two layers together. Come on, you. Come on. There you go. Okay. Make that a little more faded. There you go. So, yeah. Had a lot of fun playing spooky games to play on Halloween this month. Definitely got me Definitely expanded my horizons a bit. And in other cases, shrank them. Yeah. Alien versus Predator on Super Nintendo was pretty boring. But certain games that surprised me, like certain games that were actually good, Alien, I mean, whoops, Ah, Real Monsters, that was that was a pleasant surprise. Having a TV show licensed game be actually decent. Decent enough to get me interested in actually checking out the show, which I haven't gotten around to yet. Yeah, got like a million other shows to catch up on. Although, recently I just caught up on Robot Chicken. Pretty good stuff, I tell you what. And as usual, I'm looking forward to the next season. All right, so there's Kermit's head slightly turned to the side. What child? What do you have to bring me? Yeah, of course, he doesn't do the Kermit voice in that particular moment, but, everyone pictures Joel's dad as Kermit anyway. So, yeah, I'm drawing him as Kermit because really we don't have any other image to go on. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. I'm gonna do pretty much the same thing with little baby Joel, but. Oh, whoops. Gonna do the same kind of treatment with little baby Joel. Have his body be stationary, but his lips move. Although it might be slightly trickier, considering the layering, but I'll figure that out when I get to it. As for now, let's just finish animating Kermit. By far the easiest character to animate in this entire short. There's that, and there's that. I don't even have to use the guidelines to draw his eye. Well, his pupil, that is. Okay. There's that. And there's that. And that. Yep. So glad that that the dorm building I'm in is doing free candy. Yep. I mean, colleges. Ungodly stressful, but hey, sometimes, but little things like that are what keep me alive. Alrighty then. So, let's move on to the. Oh, wait a minute. Idea. Since the next layers pretty much just have his lips moving, I'm going to clone the ink layer. Where's that down? And there we go. We got another layer which we can edit in accordance to the next sketch. Close. There we go. Come on. There we go. A, C, V. There we go. Okey-dokey. Now let's shave all this off. Shave all of this off. Gerg. Might need to replace the tip on this, this tablet pen soon. Oh, and not sure if I expressed my financial anxiety, but you know, that's what I got. But here's the thing. I figure, you know, should probably try selling a few things on Amazon. I mean, regular people do that all the time, right? That might help a bit. Basically, I got some Pokemon cards, Power Rangers Pogs, Cyborg 009 figurines, a lot of cool stuff. Which I got duplicates of. Or stuff I don't necessarily want. Including a new in the box action figure of Lord Farquaad from Shrek. I mean, the box is a little discolored, but you know, it happens. I still think it's pretty collectible. I mean, it is new in box, and people tend to eat that shit up. So yeah, maybe selling things on Amazon rather than Craigslist will soften the blow of financial anxiety. I mean, if Craigslist didn't work, probably should try a different platform, you know? Okie-dokie. So, that was the last frame with Kermit. Now we're going to finally color these frames. Got some noisy neighbor hillbillies in the hallway. So, yeah. Do we even have anybody in the audience? No, we do not. Whatever. Getting shit done. This is gonna be in my portfolio someday, you know? Whoops. It's like I do animation as a hobby. I mean, those who are in the know would know that animation is no easy task. I mean, look at how long it takes for me to animate Kermit, just Kermit talking. Well, and that's all the frames. Took 24 minutes. See? Animation, not easy. So yeah, we got Kermit. Let's just get rid of the sketch layer. Save. Let's see, onion skin mode. Export layers. Make a folder specifically for Kermit. And there you go. Godspeed, easiest character to animate in this whole sketch, short, whatever. And there we go. Time to animate little baby Joel. Okay, so first we're going to need some color reference, so let's pull up the file I used to make that preview that I posted on DeviantArt, which I didn't show Joel yet. Silly me. But, you know, I'd like this surprise to come out of nowhere for him. So, here's this. Let's see, Control-Shift-S. Baby Joel. And save. And after this, and after these frames, there's just one more scene to ink and color, and then it's on to the backgrounds. Okay, I gotta animate a few whistles of wind, but, you know, those two scenes, that's it. And the whistles of wind thing, just gotta paint a few white lines and boom, done. You know? Anyway, let's paint little baby Joel. Lock. Actually, what I should do is preview the guess what scene again to better observe how his lips move in relation to his body. Okay, let's see. Onion skin mode, autoplay. Okay, so his chin doesn't appear to move. Kind of morphs a little. Wish I could zoom into this thing. Oh yeah, I don't really have it on screen, I forgot. Autoplay. Autoplay is a separate window. Hang on, I'll show you. Okay, so here's little baby Joel. Hey, get back here. Yeah. XSplit's being silly. But yeah, you can sort of see what I'm... Hey, stop that. Okay, fine. I'll just capture the whole dang window. Okay, maybe this... There we go. Alright, so, ugh, dang it, XSplit. Whatever. Basically, I'm going to make all of this and make a separate layer for his mouth. Alright, we're good. Close then. Okay. Anyway, time to draw this baby. Ah, dang it. Fire Alpaca's being shitty again. Hang on, gotta restart the program. Yeah, every now and then you just gotta turn it off and on again to get it to work right. Alright, preview file. And... wait a minute. Grabbed the wrong file there. Baby Joel file. There we go. Let's try this again. 10 pixel, 10 point brush or whatever. Alright, so let's get to animating. Let's get to drawing this baby. Basically, we're going to draw everything but his mouth. Anyway, this is the widest he has his mouth open. So, here's what we're going to do. Since his mouth does this sort of inward curve here, I'm going to draw his face like so. Okay, maybe not. Down to his inner lip. I mean, upper lip. Inner lip, what am I doing? There's his nose, his schnoz. There we go. Everything but his mouth. Everything but his mouth.
Everything but his mouth.
Okay, you get the idea. Gonna keep a going. Arrgh. And now for his hair. Hoop de doop. Okay. There we go. Whoops. Whoop. Okay. And there's his mutated Pac-Man head. Now for the rest of his body. Got them chunky cartoon baby hands. But since he's at a distance, that'll make drawing him a little easier. The smaller the thing you draw, the less time you gotta spend on it. Heck, I didn't even bother drawing toes on this guy. Although I should probably fix the perspective on his foot. There we go. And boop! You got yourself a baby. Arrg, now let's color him in. You know, someone actually looked at my preview GIF and basically they said that Baby Joel's face creeps them out. I don't really get why, but, you know, whatever. Doesn't bother me. People are free to interpret my art however they want, unless it's something stupid like they somehow, unless they, of course, pick it apart just for the sake of trying to make me look like a Nazi lover or something, you know? I mean, that ain't cool, man. I mean, because if there's anything I don't like, it's slander. Here we go. Now let's draw his little baby mouth. Okay, so, there's where his lip begins. One, two, three. There we go. Whoop. See if that works. Yep, that should do it. Now, for this next step, we're going to need to actually brush the some of the color in. Just for precision's sake. There we go. Yeah. There we go. That's our little baby Joel. Whoop. Awkward. Yep. Being an artist, you gotta learn to get comfortable with drawing the most awkward parts of the human body to draw. Or animal body. He looks high as fuck. Oh, jeez. He looks so high. Little high baby. Oh, God. When you take away the outlines, he looks like a meth head. Oh, God. I'm little meth baby Joel. I'm going to hell. I'm going to hell. Anyway, next mouth.
I'm a fat little baby.
Oh, God. I'm so jacked up on candy right now. Candy, candy, candy. Candy and caffeinated pop. So jacked up right now on candy and caffeinated pop. Okay, so next. Let's get this party started. Whoa! Oh, forgot to make the next mouth. Okay, I'm gonna make you number one. Okay. And Bud. There we go. Makes it a little less confusing to label your layers. But, you know, I'm a little bit lazy when it comes to that.
I'm a fat little baby. I'm a fat little baby. Fat little baby rolling in the yard. Gonna eat some ducks, then I'm gonna poop.
I'm talking like a weird guy. I'm a weird guy. I'm talking like I'm high or something.
I'm a fat little baby rolling in the yard, gonna eat some ducks, and then I'm gonna poop.
Oh, jeez. Where do I come up with this stupid crap?
I'm fat little baby rolling on your mom, gonna lick your nipples, then I'm gonna puke.
Okay. Oh man, I've had too much candy. Whoopsie. Uh, t- um,
fat little baby rolling in the bathroom, gonna eat some poop, and then I'm gonna sniff my butt. fat little baby.
Oh man, I'm going to hell.
Fat little baby.
Okay. So, that's another mouth made. He still looks high as hell.
Fat little baby, snorting some crack. Gonna... Whoa, man, I'm seeing some funky shit right now.
pretty sure crack doesn't do that, but whatever.
Fat little baby.
Jeez. I should just stop while I still have only 12 years in purgatory. Ah, jeez.
Fat little baby. Give me a kiss.
Oh, jeez. Do I sound high as fuck right now?
I'm a fat baby. Look at my baby nipples.
God damn it, I can't stop being stupid.
I'm a baby. I like the kitchen on fire. I changed my diaper. I've been eating tacos. Cause I'm a fat little baby. Let the dog lick my ear. Gonna lick my,
God, I think I ran out of stupid ideas. Thank God.
God. I'm a fat baby.
Oh, God. Okay, let me just browse through my other whatevers. Okay, so I got three more frames to look at. Okay, number 8. Here we go.
I like to light my diapers on fire. Hey, Daddy's wearing diapers too. No way. He's making Mama wear diapers. He's sniffing her butt as she's pooping her pants.
Okay, I should stop. This is getting a little out of hand.
My daddy's poop is getting into my hand.
You get out of here! Ugh, God damn it. Ugh. Oh, God dang it. I think I creeped myself out with how just out of hand that was getting. Look at his face. He's like, ooh. Oh. Wait, what's the...
Oh. Little baby fat muffin. He's like, I pinch my baby.
No. No. God damn it, just no. Ugh. Damn it. God, this is even worse than the impression of Miss Piggy I was doing last week. Man, when you burp after eating a bunch of candy, it always tastes really weird. Man, it's like your organs are rotting from the inside out.
Oh, I'm a fat little baby.
Oh, jeez. So, any of people watching my video, need some new body pillows? 'Cause I'm trying to sell some. Those of you who've seen the BRB message could see that I'm trying to sell a, Black Mage body pillow. A female Black Mage. Although, if demand is high enough, I could make a male Black Mage for the ladies. You know what I mean? Ladies. Ladies. Whoop. Accidentally gave Baby Joel meth teeth. Let's pull out the airbrush instead. Whoops. Okay. Here you go. Looking high as fuck, but at least his teeth are clean. There we go. And just one more frame to draw on little baby Joel for this scene. What child? What do you bring me? Pooh. Actually, no. The other two frames of him with his mouth shut are completely unnecessary. So, I'ma keep him as is. I like little baby Joel just the way he is. Whoop, hang on. I know that smile is in here somewhere. There we go. Look at that big doofy smile he's got there. Oh boy, hang on, I missed a spot. There we go. Fixed it all up. Let's see how everything looks. Okay, so his nose seems relatively consistent, although I'd be able to tell that better if I turned on the onion skin mode. In fact, I'm gonna go do that. Here we go. So yeah, gonna fix that just a little bit. Yeah, I want the nose to be about the same length for each frame. Oh, wait a minute, that's the, that was the airbrush. Doesn't look gravelly enough. Okay, there we go, as little baby Joel. And here comes a fart. Ugh, man, that one dragged out for a while. All right, let's Let's save and then render. Wait, what? Export layers. Okay, for some reason my file selector went to the entirely wrong folder. Okay, so let's see. And a little baby folder for a little baby Joel. Whoop, no, not the Kermit folder. Here we go. Go! Okay, well, while that's doing that, I am going to take a quick bathroom break, so be right back. Okay, we're back. So, next, we're going to animate the final scene of the short. Close that. Close that. And for this scene, we're going to need our preview image. Look at how goofy doofy he is. And as usual, we gotta export these layers into a specific folder in skin mode. Export the layers. And folder number 11. Go. Give a sec there. Arrgh. Still taking a sec. My God, this is taking a while. So anyway, the energy drink I had was Grape Mountain Dew Kickstart. Now, before we continue on, I'm just going to take a quick look at the autoplay image. Huh. Okay, so, I have a pretty good idea of what I gotta do now. Gotta, obviously, some of this... I'd show the autoplay, but as you know, as some of you may have seen, XSplit's kind of been misbehaving. But anyway, gonna once again make a stationary image while the rest of the image moves. Now, okay, so the eyebrows don't move. That's a good thing to remember. Also, for consistency's sake, I gotta remember to make the make the eyebrows thick enough. All right. Okay, little baby Joel. Okay, so we're probably going to take up the last 5 minutes of the first hour drawing the still image of baby Joel. Also, I better remember to draw his cheek there. Defying the sketch, but for good reason. And Fire Alpaca is misbehaving again, but at this point I don't really give a crap. I mean, it's still working good enough, and I don't feel like, you know, doing some restarting and such. See how that looks. Okay, next is his nose. Yeah, a lot of these shapes are easy enough that I probably don't need the dot connecting thingy. There we go. Eyebrows. Whoop, too thick. There we go. Okay, that one definitely needs the dot connector or whatever the heck it's called. The guidelines. I don't know. Did Fire Alpaca ever give an official name for this thing? Come on. Oh, hey, it's actually behaving. Yeah. Weird. Now it just randomly decides to behave. Okay. There we go. There's his face. Now let's make his body. There we go. Make his chest. And there we go. Compare that to the other image, and there we go. Now that's inked, let's color that shit. Think that candy's starting to wear off. Oh boy, these sharp corners are always a bit tricky. Are always a little bit of an inconvenience when it comes to the paint bucket. All right, color in his nipples and yeah, that'd be a good way to end the first hour of the art stream, eh? Coloring in a baby's nipples. Oh, God. Anyway, there's little baby Joel. With no mouth, no arms, and no eyes, God. Oh, jeez. In any case, well, time to move on to the second half of the stream. So, gonna take a little bit of a break, and we'll be right back. So, get this off screen. So, yeah, we'll be right back with the progress on the Kid Chameleon animation, so sit right there, we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Okay, we're back. Oh boy. Feels good to be working on this again. So, first order of business. Okay, onion skin mode, probably not the best. Action to be taken here. So, yeah. Basically, making a little short that's making fun of Kid Chameleon and how eerily similar it is to Mario. Wait, what? Oh, there we go. No, wait a minute. Maybe I should go into onion skin mode. Dang, man. I was not very efficient at making this. Sorry, guys. Gotta close and open it again. Yeah, this is back when I was still a little bit early at using Fire Alpaca as an animation tool. Yeah. I wasn't too efficient back then. I'm going to just take a look at how it looks. Let's see. Autoplay. Okay then. We're good. We're good. Yeah, just making sure I wasn't like repeating frames or anything. So yeah, like I said earlier, this is something that I plan on submitting to S Sonic Paradox's Sega Shorts if they're still doing it. I mean, when I last checked, they were still doing it, but whatever. Even if I miss the deadline, I'll finish this anyway. Not submit it, but definitely finish it. Okay, let's turn onion skin off. And then get to coloring. Alright, so here's how this is gonna work out. Just gonna use the same colors for each of the frames, see? So, got us some brown hair, white shirt, some blue jeans, some brown shoes, whoops, not brown pants. And some black sunglasses. There we go. Now we just gotta make his skin. Whoop. Maybe I made that a little too pale. There we go. There's Kid Chameleon. And to make this a little easier on myself, I'm going to quickly jot down the color palette on the side here. Just gonna jot this down and then eye drop it so that I can have an easier time coloring in the other cells. Okie Let's keep this train of a rolling. Next. Okay, let's keep going. So yeah, probably not gonna be the funnest part of the stream to watch, but yeah, apparently I inked this a long time ago. And I'm only just now coloring these frames. Hopefully this won't take too long, though. So, yeah, you guys ever played Kid Chameleon? Yeah, it was released on the Sega Genesis. Yeah, it's one of those old Sega titles that that nobody seems to care about all that much. Yeah, definitely not as beloved as Golden Axe. Or, any of the more obvious titles like Sanic. But, hey, you know. It's still technically counted as a first-party Sega title, so. Yeah, I still count it. So, yeah. Although, I could go ahead and make a short of Space Channel 5 or Nights or something. Probably Nights. I don't know that much about Space Channel 5. Yeah, here's the thing about Space Channel 5. I could never quite nail down how to play the game properly. Yeah, it's a rhythm game, but here's the thing. I mean, I don't know if it's something with my controller or whatever, but my button input seems to be very off rhythm. And quite frankly, I refuse to believe that I have bad rhythm. Why? Because I actually do a pretty decent job playing DDR. I mean, Space Channel 5 is kind of like DDR, but with the buttons. Okay, not really. Basically, you're just copycatting the moves of the aliens in front of you. Yeah, pretty simplistic premise, I know. But, if you like rhythm games, you'd probably like Space Channel 5. I myself am not the biggest fan of Space Channel 5. Now, a Sega game that I do like is Jet Set Radio. Yeah. Riding around spraying graffiti on everything. Even with your own custom designs, man. Good stuff, I tell you what. Erg. I mean, it's pretty obvious what kind of joke I could do with Jet Set Radio, being that the law enforcement is pretty much overreactive in regards to graffiti. Although, the thing is, I'm not sure how I would make the joke not so, obvious. Or in a way that other people. Oh, I just realized I accidentally gave Kid Chameleon no pants. Whoopsie! Oh, jeez. Definitely a 80s style animation error right there. Okay, so, basically, the joke is hurdy-durdy-dur. The law enforcement spends too much, has too much attention on graffiti. You know what I mean? But to be honest, I think everybody's made that joke already. So, yeah. I'm not much of a joke writer, really. So, yeah. I'll probably sit on the idea of making other Sega shorts, but for now, I'll just stick with this one that I'm working on. And I just realized these two are the same frame, I think. Yep, they are. So, no need for this layer. Let's move on to the next. Nope, that's just a repeat. Next. There we go. Whoops. Let's see, what are some other Sega games that I could like do shorts on? Could probably pick some obscure ones like I don't know. Not obscure so much as simple, but I could make one based on Space Harrier. I mean, yeah. There's definitely a lot I could make fun of in regards to Space Harrier. I mean, dude, the game is trippy as fuck, but it's still pretty fun to play. Welcome to the Fantasy Zone. Get ready. Yeah, for those of you who don't know what Space Harrier is, it's essentially this game from, keep this in mind, 1985, where you're flying around, where you're flying forward in a pseudo 3D environment. How'd these stray marks get over here? Anyway, So yeah, flying forward in a pseudo 3D environment. And you got some kick-ass music to listen to. In fact, why don't I pull up the Space Harrier theme while we're working on this? Yeah. Space Harrier. Give me a sec here. Here we go. Listen to how awesome this sounds. Let me turn my volume down a bit. There you go. Yeah, here we go. Get you pumped up, doesn't it? So yeah, you're flying around shooting alien spaceships, mammoths, mechas. It's freaking nuts, man. But I love it because of how cool it was for its time. I mean, heck. I like the game so much, I kind of wish Sega would make more entries to the Space Harrier franchise. I mean, I already know they made an homage to Space Harrier in Bayonetta, but you know, I think it would be cool if they revisited Space Harrier. Actually, you know what? I had this idea floating around in my head for a while. You know how Sonic Generations is sort of a celebrated the legacy of Sonic the Hedgehog? Well, get this. What if they made a game similar to that, but it's Sonic running around in stages related to other Sega games? I mean, think about that for a sec. You could have Sonic running through Golden Axe World, whatever that's called. The Fantasy Zone from either Fantasy Zone or Space Harrier, or both. I mean, that would be totally cool, man. Have Sonic run through all the different Sega worlds. All you fan game programmers out there, make it happen. Bam, 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 bam. Or, you know, maybe I'll get off my lazy butt and learn how to program myself, you know? Oh, man, I just can't get enough of this song. Dun, 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 dun. I mean, I would want a game like the one I just described just to hear this song, okay? Yeah, yeah, I know. Sega, Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing, but, you know, I like racing games and all, but I also really like, you know, Sonic Generations, a speed-based platformer. Like, I just love imagining what it'd be like if Sonic was running around in other Sega worlds. I mean, heck, in the Wii U version of... No, wait, not Wii U. Yeah, actually, yes, Wii U? Eh. In the Wii U version of Sonic Lost World, Sonic was running around in Nintendo worlds in the DLC. So, yeah, we've had him running around in Nintendo worlds. How about running around in Sega worlds? That would be awesome. That would kick ass. Oh, man. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. Imagine if he met Bayonetta. Oh, wait. Smash Brothers did it. Oh, jeez. But, yeah. Kind of makes me wish Sonic would appear in Project Cross Zone. I mean, seriously, what's up with that? Why isn't Sonic in Project Cross Zone? That literally makes zero sense. I mean, dude, it's not like he's Pac-Man or anything where he's too, like, simple or nonsensical to be there. I mean, Sonic has been story-driven before, so he'd fit in. I mean, and don't give me the crap about him being out of his genre, because they put Ryu and Ken from Street Fighter and Phoenix Wright in the games, so why not Sonic? It really only makes sense. I mean, Capcom has a variant of their mascot in the game. I mean, they got Mega Man X in Project Cross Zone. That's cool. But why not Sonic? Egg. I mean, sure, the game still prints money, but why not print even more money? Or do they just not want to attract the attention of the Sonic fanbase Actually, no, they're not that embarrassed about the Sonic fanbase. They're treating them actually really nicely. I mean, they're offering jobs to people who make fan games, for crying out loud. Wonder if they would offer jobs to those who make cartoons of Sonic. That'd be neat. Because I'm actually considering making, like, a fan-made opening to... Yeah. Basically, making a mock-up opening to a Sonic cartoon that doesn't exist. Oh boy. Good thing I found so many things to talk about, because we've been spending half an hour just filling in the color of Kid Chameleon. Also, I got this little cartoonish thingy going on where his eyes rise out of his sunglasses. I think that's a nice touch. Yeah, I like cartoony expressions like that. I mean, hey, Dr. Eggman did something similar in the Sonic OVA, where his eyes rose from behind his sunglasses. And unlike Sonic 06, seeing Eggman's eyes wasn't totally weird or creepy, you know? Yeah, in some scenes in Sonic 06, you could kind of see Eggman's eye. Which looked rather unsettling. Of course, that whole game was unsettling. I mean, dude, realistic Eggman? Just no, man. No. And I know Sonic has gotten really skinny, but in that game, he was too skinny. Oh boy, I was there when that game was originally making the rounds, being the then worst Sonic game of all time. But as I said in my Sonic casting video, I guess Rise of Lyric did somebody a favor. God dang it. Stop doing that. Okay. Okay. So. Whoops. It's not the right layer. Okay. Alright, so making sure I'm not coloring on the outline layer. Because otherwise, the color will overlap the outlines, that is. Man, it's a good thing that I did the thing with the with making a palette to make this progress go by quicker. Otherwise, we'd just be jumping back to previous frames over and over again. That wouldn't be any fun. Okay. How far are we up the list? Not even halfway through. Not even halfway through, man. Not even halfway through. And we got noisy people in the hall, so if you guys are hearing them, just ignore them. I can't help how noisy my neighbors are. As long as they're not gang fucking in the hallway, then I think we're good. Okay, just gotta keep coloring in the cells. Yeah, cells. Go in. Let's see, what other Sega titles can I think of that I can discuss with you guys? Oh yeah, Vector Man was a classic. Although I can't really think of anything funny to do with him. I mean, for those of you who are familiar with the Sonic Paradox forums, yeah, I realize that there's a forum where you can, find ideas to use in your shorts and use them however you please. But, I want to use my own ideas. You know what I mean? It's more impressive that way. Want to feel proud of myself knowing that I did this progress pretty much all my own. Well, except for the background music. I'm just going to be using the music from the game. Unlike my Joel Igloo short, in which my buddy Steven is going to be making the background music too. He's a music major. Okay. So we're kind of reaching the end here of this. Yeah, unlike the Joel short, this whole shebang is just one scene long. The backgrounds don't change or anything. It's a short. By every stretch of the word. And luckily, I had already finished the backgrounds to this. Now, speaking of backgrounds, as for the Joel Igloo short, excuse me. Whoops, gave him McDonald hair. As for the Joel Igloo short, I'm gonna try to finish inking and coloring the rest of the cells off stream and then get to work on the backgrounds for the next. Okey-dokey. Whoop, missed a spot there. Here we go. Yep, there's a lot of spots that I missed. Whoops. Okay, now, let's see. Classic Sega games that I like. I like Afterburner, although can't really think of any jokes per se that I can think about that, that I can tell in relation to that. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious that the game is an o sort of an homage to Top Gun or something, or, you know, just a just your standard Air Force type game, but hey, Afterburner Climax was super fun to play in the arcade, I tell you what. I mean, I know there are different like versions of Afterburner Climax, like home console versions and all, but the version I played in the arcade had a chair that rocked side to side when you made turns. Man, I was having a total blast while playing it. Rocking side to side as your ship in game did, and by ship I mean jet. I mean, God. Good on you, Sega. And I hear some variants of the original Afterburner do that too. Man, oh man. If I had the money after getting the funds to survive, I'd totally get an Afterburner arcade machine. Hurg. I mean, the arcade titles that Sega made were pretty creative at times, you know? Stuff that I never would have thought of. Except maybe the jet fighter type game, but on a technical level, even Afterburner was pretty innovative on a technical level with its pseudo 3D perspective. Like, of course, in comparison to Space Harrier, Afterburner was probably even more advanced. Because, well, you got all this stuff moving on screen. Like, in Space Harrier, everything's looking kind of flat, but in Afterburner, you got all these hills flying by at super fast speeds, and all these different jets coming out, and how the environment sort of, has this perspective tilting, Like, wherever you turned, man, it was just simply beautiful, man. It's simply beautiful. Just a beautiful, beautiful game. So, yeah, you got to hear me gush about an old Sega arcade game. So, yeah, those of you who are in the chat, or I guess in this case, the YouTube comments, what's your favorite old Sega game besides Sonic? Like, I mean, I hear Bayonetta is super popular, otherwise she wouldn't have gotten into Smash. But, you know, okay, besides Bayonetta and Sonic, what are your favorite Sega games? Actually, you know, one Sega game that totally has the potential to be continued, like in modern day, friggin' Choo Choo Rocket, man. Who remembers Choo Choo Rocket on Dreamcast and Game Boy Advance? Pretty good puzzle game, gotta say. And looking back, it probably, I'm gonna have to say it actually works a lot better as a handheld title. I mean, 'cause you know, you when solving p 'cause the thing about solving puzzles, it usually works better on mobile devices rather than on big screen TVs. I mean, that's why so many people liked playing Tetris on Game Boy. Or various other games too, you know? It's kind of like a crossword puzzle deal. I mean, you wouldn't play that on a big screen TV that you can only have in one location. No, you would want it on the go. Because you wouldn't want to be restricted to a place where you do a bunch of thinking, you know? Yeah, Choo Choo Rocket definitely worked better on the Game Boy Advance. Yep. Whoop, gotta make a new color. Actually, I think this color only appears once. Yeah, I think this pink tongue color only appears once in these frames that I inked so long ago. But yeah, Choo Choo Rocket might have some potential for some funny in there. I just can't think of it. Gotta say, Choo Choo Rocket has some catchy music. But in fact, Choo Choo Rocket. I mean, heck, even Lemon Demon, creator of the Ultimate Showdown song, made a song and related to Choo Choo Rocket. Oh, yeah. That's my jam right there. Yeah, good old Sega Boogie. Actually, another game that would probably work well being made fun of on the Sega Shorts would probably be House of the Dead. Specifically, House of the Dead 2. I mean, for those of you who have been following Joel's recent streams, he recently played House of the Dead 2. Worst voice acting of any video game, like, in history. I'm not even exaggerating. Like, look up a few cutscenes if you have to. Let's see, definitely avoiding a lot of dead air talking about random Sega games, so, let's see what others I can think of. I mean, most of the games that I browsed through on my Sega Genesis collection aren't too memorable. And by not too memorable, I mean some are just straight up obscure. Like, whoever the heck ever heard of Beyond Oasis? I mean, besides anyone who has been poking around my channel. Okay, since I actually like the Choo Choo Rocket, the Choo Choo Rocket soundtrack so much, I'm gonna play another song. Here we go. Here we go. Yeah, this game's got some really chill music, you know? I mean, dude, you could lounge to this song. Actually, it kind of sounds like porno music. I kid, though. I love Choo Choo Rocket's soundtrack. It's like it's a rule for any game developed by Sega to have awesome music, you know? It's not a guideline, it's a rule. So, yeah. Choo Choo Rocket. Wait a minute. Oh, it was also released on Android? Dude, that's sweet, man. Good move, Sega. I just might have to check that out. Because Choo Choo Rocket, man, oh man. Good times. Stimulate your brain, too. Okay, basically what you do in Choo Choo Rocket is you get all the mice to their rocket ships without getting them killed. And one time, I actually beat all the puzzles. This was back when Choo Choo Rocket was on Sega's little website called Play Sega, where they had some online games you could play for free and earn, like, Sega coins or whatever. And of course, the thing came out when I was, like, under 18. So, I couldn't join in the contest where you could win real money in exchange for the fake money, which I thought was completely stupid. Because, I mean, honestly, it's not like you're not gambling with real money, you're just entering a sweepstakes. I mean, cereal companies do it all the time without age restrictions. How come these, how come getting contest entries with fake money isn't an issue? Same goes with my Coke rewards, man. I mean, yeah. Of course, it's not like I ever pretended to understand all of Sega's decisions. Or pretty much any huge corporate company. Corporations making decisions that made absolutely no sense starting at the beginning of time itself. There we go. Arrgh. So yeah, definitely got some of the rubber animation going on here, where his face stretches and then snaps back into place. Basically what's going on in this scene is Mario is smacking him upside the head. For acting like a doof. Yeah, I know it technically has a quote-unquote obvious joke, but, you know, it's really all I could come up with, and wanted to make a traditional style animation, so, yeah, really, this is more of getting my, animation experience in, you know? Well, come on, absorb the color. There you go. Yeah, I'm definitely more of an animator than a joke writer. Which is why half my streams are so unfunny. Arrgh. Although, I'm sure if I sat down with some friends of mine, and we, played some Sega games together, I'd probably get some more inspiration for jokes. Challenge mode theme. There we go. Oh, back to my commentary about Play Sega. Yeah, once I finally did turn 18 and went on there to play some games and exchange the rings, not coins, rings, in exchange for sweepstakes entries, well, they had already shut their website down, and I was pissed, you know? I mean, you know, not only did I want to try entering the contest, but you did it by playing these classic Sega games for free. And no, I'm not just talking about, and no, I'm not talking about the Sega Genesis titles. Those were actually paid for. But what I mean is, they had games like Columns and Choo Choo Rocket. Man, I love Columns and Choo Choo Rocket. Oh boy, this super rubbery animation. So many frames. Many frames everywhere. Okay, guess I should keep thinking of what other Sega franchises I could be making fun of. Huh, check it out, only like a couple more frames to go on this guy. Then we'll put it on the autoplay. See how it looks. Looks very much like traditional animation. Or at least somewhat like it. course, I used the dirt brush on these frames to try to give it a slightly more classic look, you know? Man, how I wish I was a better joke writer. Although, I still think that the joke I wrote for that one Japanese class animation project was pretty solid. I mean, you know. I'm referring, of course, to the video simply titled, "Why Are You Watching This?" Basically, the White Ranger, I mean, not White Ranger, Green Ranger comes out and uses his Dragon Dagger to summon the Dragonzord, or in the video's case, Dragon Caesar, because, you know, Japanese class, gotta use Super Sentai for authenticity's sake. Okay, I'm gonna turn Onion Skin Mode back on. And see which one of these layers I should repeat, because I know one of them has to, I know at least a few of them have to sit still for a bit. Okay, clone, clone, clone. There we go. So, yeah, for the lip syncing here, I kind of took a little bit of inspiration from Matt Groening. Also, I forgot to paint in this guy's teeth on a frame or two, so give me just a sec while I fix that. Whoop, missed another spot. In fact, I should just do... There you go. That's way easier. Okay, so we're pretty much putting the finishing touches on this, on these frames. Let's see. Clone. 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 Okay, now I'm going to have these layers alternate. Come on, move. Gerg. Ay, sweet mother of Gherkin, this can be tedious. Clone, clone. Clone, clone, clone. Alrighty then. That should be enough cloning. Let's save this. Oh boy. I just realized I haven't really done any saving this entire time, so I hope to God this doesn't crash. Oh, it didn't. Good. Okay. Let's turn on. Okay. Let's get rid of the layer with my palette on it, because we won't be needing it. So yeah, let's save again, and then we're going to give this baby a test run. And after that, I can close up the stream. Just give it a moment to save. Okay. So, let's take a look. Yeah, it's taking a little while to load. Huh, I see the see I should fix a few parts here and there. But look at how smoothly it moves, man. It's beautiful. But before I close up the stream, I better fix up those little mistakes before I forget to. Which means we gotta browse through each individual layer. Oh, there's one mistake. Yeah, I'm not leaving that in. Yeah, why the heck did that blue spot appear? Whoop, there it is. That blue spot that I'm not sure why is there. Well, there's that. Gonna save. And then I'll export these now complete layers. Yeah! All right, export layers. Okay, a folder for the kid. And select. Alrighty then. Oh, yeah. And next we work on the frames for Mario, including making him a new jump layer. Yeah. So, this is an old project that I dug up and decided to finish. Although admittedly, I haven't recorded the lines for the voice acting yet. But I'll do that and animate over it, you know? The only character that talks in this is pretty much Kid Chameleon himself. Yeah, Mario pretty much gives him the silent treatment. But, you know, while that's exporting, I'll close up the stream. So, as usual, hang on a second. Let me get to the BRB screen. Okay, I clicked on it, so I'll just let it load. So yeah, as usual, thank you guys for watching. On YouTube, I mean, because I already know nobody attended this stream. If you do want to attend the stream, I'm going to put the link to it in the description of this video. That's twitch.tv/sergeant16bit. If you like what you saw, like, comment, like, comment, and subscribe on YouTube. Follow me on Twitch, Twitter, and Tumblr. All are in the description of the video. If you want to support me in any way, go to redbubble.com/people/sergeant16bit. That link is also in the description. And I put a little QR code next to my ad here so you can just jump to the website quickly. Anyway, on Redbubble, I'm selling stickers, clothing, and all sorts of stuff. The two little characters that you saw on the sides of the video, those are, in fact, characters that I've made stickers and t-shirts and stuff out of. As for this Dakimakura design you're seeing to the left, I'm selling DIY packs of it on DeviantArt. Or, if you want me to have it manufactured and delivered to you, then the cost is $45. Most of that goes to manufacturing. Oh, huh. And I just heard the sound that indicated that the layers we just animated are done rendering. Yay! So yeah. I'm selling all sorts of Dakimakura. Check out my DeviantArt for further designs. I'll put a link to that in the description. And, so yeah. If you like what you see, definitely consider supporting me, because we all need money to live, you know? In any case, this is Sergeant 16-Bit, and see you guys next week. Take care, everybody. I'll definitely announce what I'm going to be doing next week. Actually, no. I'm going to announce it right the heck now. Okay, so here's what I want to do for next week, now that the month of October is pretty much over in terms of the stream. So for gaming, I'm still going to be doing Mischief Makers, but for the second half, I want to do something special for you guys. I'm going to play the Pokemon trading card game online, but here's something special I want to do. I want to play it with you. That's right, I want to play it with you. So, if you guys want to battle with me on the Pokemon trading card game, definitely leave the, definitely tell me what your username is, or whatever name I can find you by on the game, so I can add you to my friends list or something. And I can have a Pokemon card game battle with you. So yeah. For those of you interested, definitely contact me with what name I can find you by on the Pokemon trading card game, and I'll play with you on stream live. As for the art stream, I'll just be doing the same thing I did here. Igloo animation for the first half, Kid Chameleon for the second half. Anyway, this is Sergeant 16-Bit. Take care, everybody. For real this time. I'm out.